Hi, this is Ethan from Dark Zebra. Today we're going to be doing a tutorial on how to launch a WordPress site using Docker. And in this tutorial, we're actually going to create three different Docker images. One image for WordPress itself, that's going to be linked to a MySQL container. And then that will be storing data into what we call a data container. And we'll cover this a little bit more in depth, but notice that these top two are yellow. That's kind of, I'm trying to indicate that they are on. The data container does not need to be on. It simply needs to run once and define what the volumes are, and then it can share those volumes where it stores its files with other containers. So we're going to create a data container. MySQL will use its volumes, and then WordPress will link to the MySQL so that I can have access to the MySQL database ports locally instead of remotely. First thing I want to cover is where Docker stores its files. This is important to understand that when we create a volume, we have in Ubuntu varlib Docker, and inside of there we have volumes, VFS, and volumes. When Docker starts an image and creates a container that has a volume defined, it will store those in a UUID named directory inside of these two directories. Right now, both of those directories are empty. That's because I have not created any containers that have volumes defined. But in the past, we ran something where I could define a volume and map it to my local present working directory. That's great for development, but in these situations, it's better to create these data containers that have volumes and allow Docker to maintain that. And we will still have access because the data is still stored in these locations, but now things like permissions are handled better. I can share this much easier across containers, so I can have more than one container using the same file system, and overall it's just kind of a better mindset to use data containers as the way where we're going to store our files rather than doing them locally in directories. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to use Docker we're going to use the BusyBox Linux distribution to create a volume. So first we're going to define, and because we're using MySQL, and there's a MySQL image here that we'll get to in a second, but everything gets stored in the varlib MySQL folder on that container, on that image. And so we want to define that we're going to be concerned with varlib MySQL and that the Docker system needs to maintain and be consistent with the data in that container. So after between starts and stops and all that, I need to maintain that data. And it also needs to be accessible to other systems. I'm also going to use an argument called name where I give it the name of my data store. This allows me to, instead of using the container IDs, I can just use the container name. Allows me to quickly identify and just makes it easier to maintain and manage. So we're going to do it in attach mode, but it doesn't really matter because we're going to just echo something like my data store. And what's going to happen is this container is going to run and then exit, as we can see here. But by running once, it has created a volume. And this is an important thing about data containers. They don't have to be running. They simply have to run once, and now I've created the volume. And if I inspect my data store, this is just a JSON. Docker inspect, this is going to return a JSON object a representation of the information about our container here. But I can look for volume. And you can see here that I've defined a volumes of var lib MySQL, and that is stored in this part of the local system. There's my unique ID for the directory. And if I copy this, you can see that I now have that directory. And if I look in VFS dir directly, I now have something there. And whenever anything writes to that now, it will be stored in this area of the local of the host system. So the second part is we need to start up our MySQL container. And as I said before, that is in the Docker registry, there is an official MySQL image. You can just copy this and go through the command quickly. Of course, we're going to run an image. We're going to give it a name. In this case, they called it some MySQL. We're going to call it my MySQL. We have to pass an environmental variable that defines the root password for MySQL to use. Right now, I'm just going to leave the default in there. And then, of course, we're going to run it as detached and run the MySQL image. There's one other thing that I want to add in here, and that is volumes from. Because MySQL, the MySQL container will be using the data container, we want to make sure that it is passing, it is grabbing its volume locations from my data store. We'll run it detached, and now we can see I have a MySQL container up and running. And if I inspect this container, we're going to see that it's pulling the volume from the exact same location that the data container is using. This really means that if I wanted to create a second MySQL database, maybe a slightly newer version or something, I could take down the old image and restart a new image and have it point to the exact same files. And it would use the same files on our host file system. And it just allows us to share data between multiple containers. The third thing we need to do is create our WordPress site. The container for WordPress will also need to link to the MySQL database that we just created. And if we do an inspection of that MySQL container, we can see that there is a value here for exposed ports, and it's 3306 TCP. That's standard for MySQL database. That port is going to be exposed locally or internally to the MySQL container, or it will be exposed outside if I mapped the port to a local, to a port on the host. But since I didn't do that, I need to make it available to my WordPress container using what's called link. And link will make it work as if it were locally installed so that the port 3306 will be available to internally to the WordPress container. So the way we do this is we run, we need to expose, or we need to link this. And the format for this is the name I have right here, and then like an internal alias for the system. So my MySQL, and then I'm gonna alias it as MySQL. I also need to expose the local, the host port 80 to the container's port 80. And then I need to run it detached. And I'm just gonna do that for WordPress, press enter. And now I have two containers running. What we can see here now is if I go in and open up this website, I am brought to the WordPress installation. I can now set up my WordPress site, install themes, whatever I need to do, all running inside of Docker containers. So once again, I have three Docker containers. One that holds the volumes so that all my data can be stored on the file system and shared between containers. One that is a service that is the MySQL database, and of course the WordPress container and service itself. One thing that is an important concept with Docker is the idea of separation of concerns. Ideally, you want to have Docker containers that do one thing and one thing only, and then you use linking and volumes from to allow them to communicate and attach to each other and share information. Well, that's all I got for today. Thanks for your time. Please leave a comment or a question in the question or the comment section below, and visit our website at darkzebra.com. Thanks.
Thanks for watching this Dark Zebra presentation. Please rate this video and add it to your favorites if you liked it. For additional content, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit us at darkzebra.com.